powerful blended learning. Her passions are teaching English to young learners and content and language integrated learning, or CLIL. Now, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let's have English as Lingua Franca with Ibu Celestine Zainuddin. Bu Yes, the floor is yours.
Okay. Can I be heard clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you very much, Ira, for the introduction. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
I just would like to quote Pak Yonos. It's a wonderful day here in Pengadegan. I do hope that you also have a wonderful day in your place. Thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much for spending your Friday morning. Yeah, Friday morning. It's close to weekend. Usually, if it is close to weekend, then what is it then? The smell of weekend is already here. We rarely would like to do things hardly, right? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I just would like to tell you a bit that Pak Yono actually at that time, or Tamba, Pak Yono and Tamba actually approached me, yeah, like 3 months ago, saying, "Bu Yes, do you have time to help us out?" Okay, remember? At that time, the title about English as a lingua franca is actually supposedly be given to Stefano. Remember that, Tamba? Okay, but I mean, yeah, one thing leads to another, and then eventually I was asked to do this. Okay, so I got like 3 months to read about this English as a lingua franca. And then when I read the articles, those journals, I see that it is not something that, like what Ira said earlier, it's not something that new, right? Yeah, we have heard these terms for years, actually. So I don't think that it is going to be that difficult to understand later. Okay, let me just share a screen here. Okay, can you see the screen clearly?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, how come it is like this? Okay. Let me just check with the screen. Okay, what about now? Okay, so this is what we are going to talk about. But before we do that, I just want to do something. This is just for the fun of it. Okay, are you aware of today's date?
11/11.
Yeah.
So I cannot help myself from Googling actually. So this morning I Googled it. Okay, what does this date signify? Okay,
so
yeah,
okay.
1/1 and 2/2.
9/11, no.
9/11.
Okay,
shopping time, ma'am.
Sorry,
shopping time.
Oh yeah, shopping. 11/11, and then 22.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So some people believe that it is a magic number.
I see.
Okay, or lucky numbers even. So it's a good day for making a wish. That's what is written on Google. So guys, if you want to make a wish for a better day today, it's time now. So hopefully we are going to have a good session today. Before we go on, I just would like to do some kind of housekeeping first. I know that TTD and QA have already informed you about this, but again, please do mute your microphone when you are not speaking so that others can be heard. Yeah, and then please do turn your video on, especially when you are speaking. Okay. We would like to see who is actually speaking, not just a blank, a monitor. Now, the next thing is please do volunteer for activities and then you will win a prize. Okay, should I show you the prize now?
Yes, please.
No, people who know me knows that I am very, very possessive of my books. I love reading so much, but there are actually a book that I haven't read before. I haven't even, opened the plastic here. So this is the thing that you are going to receive. Okay, the book is going to be given. It's a storybook. It's called The Arabian Nights.
Oh,
Arabian Nights.
That's treasure.
It's going to be stories about Shahrazad here. Okay. And then it is going to be given to those who are to one person. Okay, I only have one. To one person, the most active participants. I'm going to actually ask the help from TTD and QA to determine who the most active participant is. Okay, do we have a deal?
Okay. Can we join the race?
What do you think?
I'm also very ambitious when it comes to books.
What do you think? Okay. Let's continue here. We are going to talk about lingua franca, right? And then I would like to directly apply the kind of volunteering that is needed, right? Okay, so let's just try out. Okay, we are going to start with an activity. This is a very easy one. It's actually about the topic. I'm going to ask you, what is it that you know about lingua franca? Okay, so I need 5 people to do something here. You can actually activate your annotate. In your Zoom, yeah, and then you write something. What is, okay, the question is, what is lingua franca? What do you know about lingua franca? How do you know about this and stuff like that? And then could you please write your answers there? Okay, TTD and QA, I will need your help to
okay, do this. First, yeah. 5 to raise your hands.
Yeah, please write something there.
Nobody?
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 I think
one. You can start writing.
Okay, Pak Tony, go ahead. Write your answer.
I can. There is no annotate button on my screen.
Oh, you have no annotate button on your screen?
Disabled, probably. Disabled by the host.
Hold on a moment. Let me.
Oh, disabled by. Oh, okay.
Okay,
that
unites.
Okay, that's a good one. I like that.
Oh, yeah.
The button is in option, Paroni.
Yeah, okay.
The option and then annotate.
Wow.
Okay. Teriana, yes.
Your name, please. Who wrote that?
Teriana.
First one?
Teriana from Lampung.
Teriana Lampung, okay.
Come again, sorry, Diana.
Teriana.
Teriana.
Teriana from Lampung, and then Adisa. Paroni, you're still waiting for your annotation.
I think Paroni is typing.
Pitri is here.
Pitri is typing. We need two more. One more.
Paroni, have you found the annotation?
Yes. Biasa jadi host lupa kalau ada di situ.
Okay, that's nice. A bridging language.
Okay.
Okay. A language that is commonly used in certain area by the people to do what?
Do we still need one more?
Maybe I can say it like that way. To communicate.
Yeah. Novisa Petri, yes, please.
So that you can be understood
by each other. I'm still on the way, sorry.
Oh, so
I cannot really use the annotation now.
Okay.
Is that okay? So lingua franca that I know is like a kind of language that is used to communicate and also to what to in the past it was used to trade between uh-huh. one trade. Mm-hmm. So for one group of among groups of people, so like one group of people can speak a different language and then the other group maybe has a different language and then they use one lingua franca to connect them. Mm-hmm. So that's what I've ever heard about. Mm-hmm. So it's a language that can connect different groups of people to get together, to trade, to communicate.
Okay.
Is that
that's good. Thank you very much, Achia.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Okay. The word communicate comes up a lot. It's a language. It's a unite so that they can interact. Okay, the number one is actually very much a real definition of a language systematically used to make communication possible between groups of people who do not share a native language or dialect, particularly when it is a third language that is distinct from both of the speakers' native languages. Okay. Yep. Based on your answers, a language that unites, a bridging language, based on those answers, I think that you have a pretty good idea of what lingua franca is actually. Thank you. Yep. Now.
Before we go on, ma'am, there are also some people who also wrote on the chat.
Oh,
here Miss Fitriani said something like bahasa pengantar. It's also
something a question. Like bahasa pengantar. Okay, bahasa pengantar. Okay, what do you mean by bahasa pengantar?
Not sure. Hopefully, Miss Fitriani can explain more about it.
Oh, a language that connects. Is that what you are saying by pengantar?
Probably because that's what she wrote here. Okay, another one is from Miss Juni.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, she said that, okay, according to her, okay, lingua franca is language that is adopted as a common language between speakers whose native languages are different.
Okay, speakers mm-hmm. whose native language are different. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Again, what I can say is that you have a pretty good idea of what lingua franca is. And then if it is English as a lingua franca, of course, you can actually define what English as a lingua franca is. Yeah, you have a pretty good idea. So can I just stop now because they have already understood, Tamba?
Okay.
Okay, you have a pretty good idea. Okay, so activity one, done, okay. You have the thing about what lingua franca is, and then our session is going to be more on, so then what, you see? So what are the implications of, if we use English as a lingua franca? That's the thing. Now, after this, we are going to move on to activity two, in which there is also, I need three volunteers actually to share their thoughts. Okay. What you need to do actually for the activity two is like this. You are going to watch a video. And then in this video, I would like you to try to connect the video with what is it that you have already written here. Okay, how is lingua franca related to this video? Do you think that you can do that? Okay, so you need to watch your video and then afterwards you need to pay attention to what is it that they are saying because there are two people talking. Yeah, and then afterwards share your thoughts. Okay, so Ibu Ira, three volunteers, like what we did with Achil earlier.
Mm.
Okay. Ready, so everybody?
The first three to raise hands.
Okay. Okay, can I be helped by removing the annotation?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. So this is it. Yeah. So what is it that you need to do first? You just
watch the video.
Video and then pay attention to that. And then after that, you?
Share thoughts.
Okay, then. Yeah.
say hello to start.
Hello.
I didn't understand your response.
Allô.
Please say hello to start.
Hello.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't understand you. Could you please repeat your response?
Hello.
I'm still waiting for your response. Please say hello to start.
Hello. Allô. Hello. Hola.
Calling iRabbit International Help Desk for assistance.
Hello, sir. Thank you for purchasing the iRabbit, your own personal digital animal. Roger, at your service, sir. Before I can help you out, could you please spell your name for me, sir?
T. Ash. E. E.
Is that an O, sir?
Yes. E. R. One more R. Y.
That is not a letter, sir.
It's the letter Y.
Can I just call you Greg, sir?
I'm Thierry. Thierry.
Bien sûr, monsieur. How can I help you today, Mr. Greg?
I tried to start my iRabbit, it doesn't work. I'm very tired and hungry.
Sir, if you're hungry, I can call you back after lunch.
No, wait! I shake the rabbit, it doesn't function.
Sir, please do not shake your iRabbit. Press the tail to start.
I tried. It never works. I ate the rabbit.
Sir, your 1-year limited guarantee doesn't cover chewing or biting the device.
No, I hate the rabbit.
Heating can cause fire in your house, sir.
No, I eat the rabbit!
I understand that you are a non-vegetarian, Mr. Greg, but I would personally advise you to not eat the equipment, sir.
Can I talk to your chef, please?
I'm calling from iRabbit International Help Desk. It's not a restaurant, sir.
No restaurant. I would like to talk to your chief.
We are based in a developed country here. We don't have any chiefs or tribes now.
But I paid a lot of money. It is not cheap.
Exactly, sir. It's a rabbit, not a sheep.
I mean, it is not cheap.
It's a rabbit, not a sheep.
It's not cheap.
It does have an electronic chip inside.
Please, focus on my problem.
Don't quite understand you, sir.
Please focus.
I beg your pardon?
Please focus on the rabbit.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't accept that kind of language. Thank you for purchasing the iRabbit, your personal digital animal.
Hello.
Welcome, Greg.
The name is Thierry.
Nice to meet you, Thierry. What can I do for you, Thierry?
Okay, then.
So, we have two people already raising hands.
Okay, yes, let's hear. So
can
let's
you
see what happened.
Activate your video and share what happened.
Who's? It's Juni, right? Juni or?
Yeah, Juni. Bu Juni?
Okay. Yes.
Juni.
Okay.
Can I just stop sharing, Ira?
Yes.
So just listen.
So, Bu Juni.
Okay. Good morning, Ibu Celestine.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning. Good
morning.
I'm sorry, good I'm morning. Using phone, not my laptop.
That's okay.
That's okay.
Okay. And then you asked my ideas about the video.
Yeah.
Then I thought, I guess, when I watched the video, there is a misunderstanding between mm-hmm. the the customer, and the person who handled the question. It happens since the customer has different dialect or mother tongue. Maybe it is influenced by his mother tongue, and so the pronunciation is not correctly pronounced, and it is misinterpreted with the person who listened. Actually, I guess the best problem here is mispronounced or spelling, and influenced by dialect, mother tongue, or it is also the lack of understanding between the two of them. Okay. Yeah, since they are from different countries, the other from it's like India, and the other one is from Russia, like that. So that's they have different what is it? And then yeah, sorry, I guess the customers also has a lack of English, English. In pronunciation and spelling, I guess.
That's all. Oh, okay. 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 Thank you very much.
Okay, that's all I think. Thank you.
Really? Okay. So you mentioned about different dialect, different mother tongue, and then mispronunciation as well as spelling, as well as the lack of understanding. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. That is a problem in my in their interaction. Thank you very much. What about others?
Two more people.
Yeah.
So raise your hands. Activate your video. Yeah. That's
Rudy.
Participants. This one is Ibu Fitri. The next one is Ibu Fitri. Yes, Ibu Fitri. Can you activate your video? Where are you from, by the way, yeah. Ibu Fitri?
Ibu.
Oh, from Cibubur. Yes, please. Okay, so what do you think?
The same like before, the problem is actually the language barrier. But the problem is there's no effort from the customer service actually, which actually should try the best effort to understand the customer. So there should be an effort using another help, like maybe a body language or any other sources to try to understand that the customer is from different part of the world with a different language. So yeah, basically there's no effort from the customer service trying to understand what message that the customer sent.
That's all. Oh, thank you very much, Fitri. Okay, the language barrier, and then there is no effort from the customer service, yeah, to make it clear. Oh, okay, that's interesting. That's interesting. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ibu Fitri. Another one?
There are still two other.
Members. Yeah, okay. Miss Celestine, this is Rudy.
Rudy,
Rudy.
Hi, yes, Miss Celestine.
Oh, hello,
it's nice to meet you nice finally meet you. Because I have heard your name for so many times.
Oh, now okay. I meet you.
All right. So, Miss Celestine, I think this is a very common problem happening because of the use of non-standard English in many countries because of the influence of their local dialects. So, because, of course, it can happen everywhere. In this case, it was in France, and that it can happen here in Indonesia. We have our own English dialect in the English, English, Indonesian English, or Malay, and so on. So, this is very common. So, because the, what you call that, the people in many parts of the world, don't speak English in a standard English. That's the problem. Mm-hmm. I guess. Mm-hmm.
So you mentioned about the standard English. So meaning that there is, if there is a standard English, there is a non-standard English as well, right?
Right, because in terms of pronunciation,
terms and of then, pronunciation.
Grammar and so on.
Oh, okay. Ibu Juni earlier also mentioned pronunciation and then you add it with grammar. Okay.
Right.
Oh, okay. That's nice. That's good to hear. So and then in relation with lingua franca, is that how is the interaction connected to the to lingua franca actually?
It can create a misunderstanding, I guess, about for instance, if English is chosen as the lingua franca, but people don't really stick to the standard English, then it will create this kind of miscommunication because some will pronounce wrongly and others will misinterpret this.
Mm, okay, thank you very much, Farudi. Thank you very much. Okay. Does this happen also for us Indonesian when we talk to others?
Oh, so many times, I guess. Yeah, mm-hmm. we have, you know, different kinds of funny things like the video that you just showed us, right? Uh-huh. Yeah, mm-hmm. Okay. Because we have, you know, the Japanese speak English in different way compared to the Bataks and mm-hmm. maybe Sundanese and so on, right? Uh-huh. Even myself. You know, have been teaching English for, you know, for more than 10 years. Uh-huh. I still cannot, you know, ignore my dialect, my local. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Yeah. Yeah. Me too. Pak. Don't worry about it. Okay. Yes. I'm going to share. I'm going to go back to share screen something. Yeah. Now here. I think we need to retrace our steps back, okay? Because we are probably using the terms interchangeably, okay? This is going to be another activity. This is a matching activity, okay? I need 4 volunteers here in this case, okay?
4 volunteers?
3 volunteers, sorry.
3 volunteers. Volunteer. The first 3 to raise hands, please.
Just raise hand. Okay. So what you see here is that on your left, there are 3 terms being used when we talk about language. Yeah, that is this EIL, WE, ELF, and EFL. What you need to do is to find its match. The first one is to find the what those words stand for. Okay, on the right. And then after that, you need to find also the definition of the term. Okay. Is that clear?
Okay.
Okay. So you need to find the what that term stands for and then what the definition is. Okay. Because it's related to what you have already explained about that lingua franca, about what misunderstanding that happened in the video. Okay, yes.
Next. Raise hands, please.
Ada Anissa.
Anissa, one.
Arintika.
Anissa, Arintika.
Arintika, no, just joined the session.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, Anissa, could you please choose which term that you need to could you please say it?
I did, ma'am. It's a we word English. Uh-huh. It's a localized varieties of English spoken throughout the world by people of diverse cultural backgrounds in a wide range of sociolinguistic context. So we definitely outnumber the native speakers.
Okay, that's good. Other things that you know about world English?
If I'm not mistaken, it's from Professor Kachru in 1970s something.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's good. Okay, that's world English. What about others? What is it? Fitri, yeah? What is the name of Fitri? Who has the blue?
Fitri. Hello, Fitri. Hello. Can you unmute yourself, please?
Yeah, Bu.
So, what is your answer?
EFL. English as a foreign language. It is a form of international variety of English.
Others, do you agree with that?
Or I changed my mind. English when it is used by non-native speakers to communicate with native speakers.
Okay. The second one is the comment.
Yeah.
Okay. We change our minds.
Okay. So you have English as a foreign language. English when it is used by non-native speakers. Yeah. Okay. And then the other one, tadi ada namanya
siapa? I think Ibu Juni is also trying.
Ibu Juni is also trying.
Juni, can you unmute yourself, please?
Yes, ma'am.
So what is your answer?
ELF, English as lingua franca. And English when it used by non-native speaker to communicate with native speakers.
Okay.
Is that correct?
So, I don't know. What do you think? Because your answer is almost similar to Fitri. So which one is it then?
Okay, we have is it Mr.
Lingua Franca.
Mr. Adiana raise hand.
Yeah, well. Mr. Adiana.
So, Mr. Adiana,
you're still muted, sir.
Unmute yourself, please.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm Adiana from Bali. This is my second time to join LIA.
We remember.
Yeah, thank you. Continuing the answer before, LS. Is English as a lingua franca, and the definition is English when it is used between two or more people who do not have the same first language.
Okay. As opposed to EFL, which is?
EFL.
Is that what you are?
ELF.
Okay. ELF, sometimes I get confused. ELF, ELF, or EFL. Sometimes
ELF.
Could you please repeat so that everybody can?
Okay, thank you.
This one is ELF.
ELF, yes. ELF, what is ELF? It stands for English as a lingua franca. And the definition is English when it is used between two or more people who do not have the same first language.
Okay, so meaning that in your opinion, EFL is?
ELF, sorry.
Yeah. Previously, it is ELF, yeah? Because there was a confusion between ELF and EFL earlier.
Okay.
So, can someone once again tell me what EFL stand for?
Raise your hands, please.
EFL.
EFL.
EFL now. English?
Foreign language.
As a foreign language. Ibu Eka. And then which one is the definition?
EFL.
Yes.
EFL is English for foreign, English as a foreign language. Then, English when it is used by non-native speakers to communicate with native speakers.
Okay, that's very good. Okay, yes. Thank you very much, Ibu Eka. So meaning it's the rest is EIL, English as an international language, right? English as an international language. It's a kind, it's a form of international variety of English. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, let's see. When Anisaya, if I'm not mistaken, talked about world Englishes, which is coined by Kachru, Kachru decided to to categorize people based on their cultural backgrounds. Yeah. Okay, it's very much localized varieties of English spoken by people of diverse cultural backgrounds. Okay, that's what Kachru said. It's actually earlier than 1970s, Anisa. Okay. And then we also have this English as a foreign language. Remember, we used to have, okay, because I'm a teacher of LIA, when I was trained by LIA, in the old days, we have T3E. Okay, now we have TEFL. So meaning the kind of English that is used is a kind of English used by those native speakers, right? And then there is this English as a lingua franca. Let's see. Can I be helped with the annotation?
Yes, ma'am. Let's see.
Bapak Ibu, for this session, okay, I'm going to actually use the definition like this. Yeah. ELF. Okay. ELF is actually a means of communication between speakers who do not share the same mother tongue and who use English for English as a lingua franca purpose. So, ELF is a means, yeah, of communication. This is not a kind of English. It's not a variety of English, but this is the way to communicate, yeah, with people whom you do not share the same mother tongue. Okay, and then you will see that that there are four beautiful ladies. Yeah, we are going to talk about them later on. Now, let's continue a bit. Okay, this is what the circle, yeah, by Kachru, the inner circle, the outer circle, as well as the expanding circle. My question will be, do you still remember the name of those people who in the video?
Theory. And Raj.
Ah, kira-kira, yeah.
Right.
Do you think Theory and Raj, which circle do they belong to?
Outer.
Who?
Raj would be outer circle.
Raj would be outer circle. What about Theory?
Theory is in the
maybe expanding.
Expanding.
Theory is from which country?
France.
Judging from the sound, I think he's French.
Okay, mm-hmm. Yes. So actually, he belongs to the expanding circle.
Mm-hmm.
Similar to Indonesia, Japan, Korea, and so and so. Okay. Raj belongs to the outer circle. And then you see the connection between the inner circle and the outer circle. Okay. The countries in the outer circles are actually countries that are what?
Commonwealth.
Yeah, the Commonwealth. Yeah. So their English is, yeah, we can call it good. Okay. Now, look at the many users, yeah, of English in those circle. Inner circle, 380 million users. Outer circle, 300 million. And then the expanding circle, up to 1 billion users. Now, when we do EFL, foreign language, which language do we use? Which language from which circle do we use?
Maybe number expanding circle?
No. When we teach English as a foreign language.
Oh, inner circle.
The inner circle. Because we have, are you teaching or are you learning the American English or British English? Isn't that true?
Yes, yeah. American,
yeah,
English.
Yeah, so yeah. Those language from the inner circle. So we have American English, British English, Canadian English, and so and so. And then they are very proud because they own the English language. Yeah, those people from the inner circle. However, my question, my other question is, if we do ELF, itu which one? Who do ELF?
The expanding circle to the inner circle.
Okay, so kira-kira, what do you think? How many people are there doing the ELF?
1 billion.
It's actually close to 2 billion users now. 2 billion users. Now, that got you thinking, right? That got me thinking. We, up till now, we do have TEFL. Teaching English as a foreign language, right? And then it's going to be the consumption of those people in the inner circle, okay? So shouldn't we teach actually English as a lingua franca because it is being used by everybody in this world, okay? Hold that thoughts, yeah? Okay. Yeah. Now, we are going to go to another activity. Okay.
Three volunteers needed.
Okay.
The first three to raise hands.
Okay. You mentioned something about misunderstandings. Yeah. Ibu Juni mentioned something about misunderstanding at the very beginning, right? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
And then you mentioned about pronunciation. The misunderstanding is caused by pronunciation. Now,
yes, ma'am.
Ibu Juni believed in that. What about others? Is it only pronunciation that made the misunderstanding happen? What about others? Yeah. I need to hear your thoughts.
The lack of vocabulary, maybe, ma'am.
The lack of vocabulary. Who is saying that?
Juni.
Oh, Ibu Juni again. Okay, others.
Different cultural background.
Sorry.
Different cultural background.
Okay, mm-hmm. That can also cause misunderstanding. Who is saying
like
that?
It's Novi, actually.
Novi. Aduh, Acil, your voice is better.
Mm-hmm. So it's just like when Thierry mentioned I Greg.
Yeah, well, okay, I
Greg.
Y Greg.
Y Greg.
Y
Greg. Y Greg.
Okay.
Uh-huh. I didn't know it exists. Y Greg.
Okay. Other things? Grammar is not something that you pay attention to, yeah?
Yes, of
can
course.
Can grammar yeah, become the cause of misunderstanding?
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so, Miss. Mm. Right. Yeah, because our lingua franca is also influenced by our local dialects when.
Okay.
Right.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So we mix up between Indonesian grammar and English sometimes.
Ah, okay. This Parudi, right?
Right. Yeah. So yeah, I wish I could get the prize someday. Because Miss June is there, my competitor.
Okay, so we have a different background, yeah, cultural background. We have pronunciation. We have grammar. Those three are what comes to your mind when the interaction happened between Raj and Thierry. Anything else?
The mean of communication, it means like it's not like face to face directly. Sometimes.
Mm. So the mode of the what is it then, the model of the interaction, yeah, if yes. It is face to face, and then if it is online, it's going to be different. Is that what you are saying?
Yes, well, exactly.
Okay, that's all good what is it then answers. Thank you very much. Let me just share one now. But I mean, you cannot just claim those things, right? You need to have a certain amount of data to claim that pronunciation is a problem, right? Grammar is a problem. Cultural background is a problem, okay? That was your assumption. You need more than just assumption, right? Okay, so you remember these four ladies, yeah? Those four ladies, they actually study about this English as a lingua franca, and then they use the power of corpus, yeah, to help them make certain claimed, right? So we have Penny Err, we have Ibu Barbara Seinhofler, Jennifer Jenkins, and Ibu Anna Maurenen, if I'm not mistaken. And then one of the corpuses is called voice. It is Vienna, Oxford, International Corpus of English. Okay, it is a computerized open access corpus capturing more than 1 million words of naturally occurring spoken English as lingua franca interactions. Can you imagine? So it is a very huge data, a big data, and then you can use it to your, to your heart's content, yeah, what it is. What is it that you are going to research on? Okay. Now, about this voice, okay. In your opinion, based on the data that is mentioned, that is, what is it then, being put, recorded in voice, what do you think the kind of study that you can do? What is it that you can study based on the data that you have in on voice? Okay. So they do study, they do research at the level of language, at the level of lingua cultural background of the interlocutors, and then as well as the level of the domain. Okay. You did mention about cultural background earlier. You mentioned about language, phonological features, that is pronunciation. And then you, I don't remember, yeah, who mentioned something about pragmatic features. I don't remember. Oh, ini Fitri, if I'm not mistaken. She mentioned something about there was no effort from the customer service. Yeah, I mean, there should be, I mean, he should have used a kind of body language, a kind of strategies, yeah, to help theory to understand the conversation so that he can be understood as well. Okay, as well as yeah, like what Pak Rudy has mentioned earlier about grammar, lexical grammatical characteristic of ELF interaction. Okay, so most research are actually done at the level of language, focusing on pronunciation, pragmatics, as well as grammar, yeah, to be easy, so that it's easier for us to understand. But research can also be done at the level of lingua cultural background of the speakers, of the interlocutors, yeah, for specific regions. I've come across studies of research done in Africa, actually, and somewhere in Asia as well. Or you can also do research in terms of the domain, okay, the kind of language that is being used in international business setting, for instance, or in a very casual conversation and stuff like that. Okay, I'm going to, yeah, we are going to focus on the language, yeah, since we are language teachers here. So we are going to talk about these phonological features, pragmatic features, as well as the grammatical characteristics. Okay. Now, for activity 5, I need volunteers, actually. Okay. It's a race, so meaning that everybody can unmute yourself, okay, and then we are going to look at the samples that I took from voice. Okay, so I took 6 samples of voice of people from different countries. There they are. So Putri must be from
Indonesia.
And Hua is from
China.
Okay, so you know your flags, yeah. Olivia is from
UK.
Japan.
Ahmad, Malaysia.
Malaysia. And
Singapore.
US, United States.
United States. Okay. If we go back, okay. Putri belonging to which circle?
Expanding.
What about Haruto?
Expanding
the same.
Ahmad.
Outer circle.
Yeah. What about Olivia?
Yeah, inner.
And then Liam?
Inner. Also
inner.
Okay. In your opinion, yeah, which of these 6 people will be very difficult to be understood?
Naruto.
Naruto.
Naruto ya. Not Putri.
Nope.
Are you sure? Because we are Indonesian, yeah.
Yeah, because she is Lia students, I guess.
Because she's Lia students. Okay. Okay. The one that is mostly who will be your favorite, you think? Olivia or Liam?
I think Liam.
Liam. Not thanks Ahmad. To Hollywood movies.
Ahmad, I think.
Liam.
Yeah, so this is what we are going to do. I need volunteer. What's it then? Five, yeah. How many tadi? Six people. This is what I'm going to do. You see on the right, there is the picture of speaker. Then there is an audio file of each and every one of those six people. Yeah. What you need to do is actually to match. Once I play the audio file, then you have to guess. Oh, it's Fitri. Oh, it's Fen Hua. Oh, it's Olivia, right? So I'm not going to play it all. Once there is an answer, and then I'm going to stop. Then we'll discuss it. Okay? Is it understood?
Okay.
Okay. So what you need to do is to...
Listen and guess.
Yes.
And shout the name.
Yes. Okay. I'm going to start from... I'm going to need help here from Titi Dini. Okay. So who is actually the first who answers correctly? Yeah. Okay. Number one. Ready, everybody?
Ready.
Audio on, everyone. Is it better audio on or is it better with chat, Ira?
Chat is easier.
Okay.
So the first number one, yeah.
Put your name in the chat.
Okay, so this is number one.
Well, here's a story for you. Sarah Perry was a veterinary nurse who'd been working daily at an old zoo in a deserted district of the territory, so she was very happy to start a new job at a...
Stop, ma'am. Private practice.
Okay.
I have answers already.
Ronnie.
The first one is actually Bu Teti.
Oh,
Bu Teti.
Yeah.
Oh, Bu Teti. Yes, Bu Teti. Yeah. I cannot see everybody's...
You said Liam.
Yeah. Okay.
That's Liam.
That's correct.
Okay.
So you know your English, right? So that's a kind of American English that we have, yeah? American English. By the way, do you teach American English or British English?
More to British, more to American.
We are going to talk about that.
Standard English.
Okay, yeah. But which standard, Axia? Okay. What about number two? Are we ready?
Yeah.
Okay, ready to type in your answers?
Oh, okay. Number two.
Here's a story for you. Sarah Penny was a veterinary nurse. Working daily at an old zoo in a desert district of the...
Stop.
The first answer is from Ibu Rosita and then Fenhua.
Yeah. Okay, but there someone is circling Ahmad.
Actually, the second answer is from Ibu Rihastuti and that's not Ahmad, but Haruto.
Oh. Okay. Yes, I'm going to. What is it then? To wait, okay? Because I would like you to differentiate, yeah, between Haruto or Ahmad atau Fenhua, yeah, later, yeah. Okay. Okay. The answers later. Number three first.
Okay. Type in your answers.
Okay. There is something about my mouse here.
When the sunlight strikes raindrops in the air, they
act as a prism. Is it really that obvious?
Yes, Indonesian banget.
There is no Indonesian banget. Okay, Putri. Okay, you're right. Okay,
Putri.
Number one who got the correct answer is Bu
Fitri.
Okay. Now let's do number four.
Chat or circle the picture?
Chat. Actually, the name in the chat, please.
Okay. Use the chat.
Ready?
Ready? Number four, yeah? Okay.
When the sunlight strikes raindrops in the air, they act as a prism and form a rainbow. The rainbow is a division of white light into many beautiful colors.
Okay, we have answers already.
Okay, my mom, already
answers.
The first answer is from three, and the answer is
Haruto. Okay. Nobody answers differently? Everybody answers Haruto?
Some of them have different answers.
Fenhua and Haruto.
Okay, yeah. Haruto and Fenhua. Which, what do you think, guys?
I guess it's Chinese.
There is one person who says that it's Ahmad.
Oh, there is also someone mentioned about Ahmad. Okay.
Yeah.
We go on. And then you can see the difference. Okay, number five.
Well, here's a story for you. Sarah Perry was a veterinary nurse who had been working daily at an old zoo in a deserted district of the territory. So she was very happy to start a new job at a superb private practice in North Square near the Duke Street Tower.
Well,
that area was much nearer.
Well, here's a story for you. Sarah Penny who'd been working daily at an old zoo in a deserted district of the territory.
So she was there. Shape of long run out. Superb private practice in North Square near the Duke Street Tower.
So she was there.
That area was
much nearer.
What's going on? There is something wrong with the because I press a button, a wrong button.
Oh,
sorry.
But we've got answers already, ma'am.
Yeah, you have answers already. And then what's the answer?
Haruto. Haruto. Yeah,
Haruto
and Ahmad.
Haruto and
Haruto. Mm-hmm. I think it's Haruto.
Ibu Siti Andela says that it's Haruto.
Oh, okay. Mm. Yeah. Okay, so we have a problem actually between Haruto, Ahmad, and Fenhua, yeah.
I think it's Ahmad, ma'am, because the Malay dialect is so prominent.
I guess so.
Oh, you guess so. Okay. Okay, I'm going to play that one more time, but let's just finish with number six, okay? You know what number six is then?
Yeah.
Duke Street Tower. The area was much nearer for her and
when the sunlight strikes raindrops in the air, they act as a prism and form a rainbow.
What happened?
Double song.
I lost this one. Number six, okay.
Well, here's a story for you. Sarah Perry was a veterinary nurse who had been working daily at an old zoo in a deserted district of the territory.
Olivia.
So she was very happy
That's Olivia. Okay. So you can actually identify Putri.
Yes.
Olivia and Liam.
Yes.
However, you got confused between Fenhua, Haruto, and Ahmad, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. Itu nomor berapa aja tadi ya? I forgot the number. Okay, here, I'm going to play this one more time and then I'm going to tell you from which country does this person belong to. Number five, yeah? Whoa.
Well, here's a story for you. Sarah Perry was a veterinary nurse who had been working daily at an old zoo in a deserted district of the territory. So she was very happy to start a new job at a superb private practice in North Square near the Duke Street Tower. That area was much nearer for her and more to her liking. Even so, on the first morning, she felt stressed.
I think
okay.
Haruto.
So,
That's Ahmad.
Yeah.
Ahmad.
Oh,
the thickness of this Malay accent is clear. So number five is actually
Ahmad Haruto, yeah.
Okay. So the correct answer is from Ibu Eko Munjiati then.
Okay.
Yay. Bu Eko met a lot of Malaysian people.
Oh, that's why. That explains.
Okay, now we need to establish the connection between Haruto and Fenhua here. Okay, now what do you think? Number two is
Will, here's a story for you. Sarah Penny was a veterinary nurse who had been working daily at an old zoo in a desert district of the territory. So she was very happy to start a new job at the Super Bowl private practice in North Square near the Duke Street Tower. The area was much nearer for her and more to her liking. Even so, on her first morning, she felt stressed.
I think that's
two is Fenhua.
Fenhua.
Yes.
Yeah. I agree
with Fenhua. Then this is Haruto.
So Ibu Rosinta is correct then.
Like strife raindrops in the air, they act as a prism and form a rainbow. The rainbow is a division of white lights into many beautiful colors. These take a shape of long round arch with each part high above and its two ends apparently beyond the horizon. There is, according to legend, a boiling pot of gold at one end.
Ah, okay.
Speaking syllables.
That's Haruto.
Yeah.
Haruto. Mm.
Yeah. Japanese speaking syllables.
Japanese, yeah.
So Ibu Fitri is correct. Ibu Fitri
is correct. Okay, thank you, Irak. Okay, now can you imagine this situation? So you heard them talking. Can you imagine what happened if Putri, Fenhua, Olivia, Haruto, Ahmad, and Liam are co-workers? They're working together on a project to create a marketing campaign. What do you think will happen during the interaction? Anybody? Can you imagine what happened if it was Raj and Thierry, that thing happened? If
they are six,
actually, so far from the clip, their English is quite audible, mm-hmm. but here and there, they will need to use a lot of gesture to explain mm-hmm. to their friends mm-hmm. or mm-hmm. to their mm-hmm. colleague, because maybe there will be some kind of an information gap.
Mm-hmm.
But I think it's going to be minimal, maybe only about 20 or 30%, because their English is already quite good.
Mm-hmm. Okay, but I mean, misunderstanding, will that happen?
There is still a possibility, about 20-30%.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, so you can boil down to how many percent? Yeah, that's Ibu Della for you. Okay, that's good. Yeah, Sri Hastuti is raising her hand. Do you have
yes.
a yes?
Okay, so I guess since they come from different circles,
mm-hmm.
I guess most of them will understand the people from the inner circle. Yeah, mm-hmm. Olivia mm-hmm. and Liam. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. So they won't have a problem understanding them, but probably Liam and Olivia will probably have a problem understanding Fenhua, Abuto, Putri, and Ahmad. Mm-hmm. I guess mm-hmm. yeah. Mm-hmm. So yeah, again, I guess gestures will play important roles there, and yeah, probably they can also use a written form of English.
Oh.
To, yeah. To make their what they meant by saying something understood, I guess yeah, I guess that's what will happen.
Okay, there is an interesting what is it then from Anissa here? The chat from Anissa.
Can I read it for you?
Yes, please.
They will have different views on what platform to use, copywriting, and word choice because they have different cultural background.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Those things, yeah. Those are being actually researched. Yeah, if you do English as a lingua franca. Okay. Now, Atil, do you want to say something?
Yes, ma'am. Yeah. I agree with everybody here, but mm-hmm. like I also have a different kind of experience. So in mm-hmm. this case, mm-hmm. in my experience, we get it, sometimes we get difficulties to understand the inner circles.
Uh-huh.
And the inner okay. circles understand that sometimes it's hard for us from the expanding or the outer circle mm-hmm. to understand them. So mm-hmm. what we usually do is like everybody like try to meet halfway. So like mm-hmm. lower, mm-hmm. lower that like make like speak slowly. And then mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. the others also try, well, one side, they try to put it like a bit higher, but there was an inner circle. They try to put it a bit lower. So because they understand also like even though they are native speakers, but they have dialects.
Yeah,
they are not easy to be understood as well. Yeah. Okay, especially when we deal with British or New Zealanders. Okay, yeah, they have pretty very different dialects. So yeah, it's not like we understand them only, but they also have the effort to understand us.
Yeah. Okay. So it goes both ways. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So you need to negotiate. You need to adapt. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. That's good. That's good. Then you can use actually the data in in voice. Yeah. To do your research on that, on pragmatics actually. Okay. Yep. Okay. Now based on, I'm going to continue unless there are other comments. No comments? No. Okay, so I'm going to continue here. Now, Ibu Jenkins, Professor Jennifer Jenkins, this is her book. Okay. Yeah, she actually coined this idea of lingua franca core. What is lingua franca core? So based on the corpus that you have already seen, she actually select pronunciation features of the English language that is recommended as a basis in teaching English as a lingua franca. So she actually focused more on the pronunciation because that's what you mentioned first, yeah? The problem is actually the pronunciation. Let's look at her findings. I took it from this position papers from OUP, English Pronunciation for a Global World. And then this is the list that she has already came up with. Okay. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number 2 and number 6 are actually not from Ibu Jennifer Jenkins, yeah. So I'm going to ignore it for a bit, yeah. We are going to concentrate on the other 4. So according to Ibu Jennifer, yeah, the pronunciation, the priority should be on the most consonant sounds. Yeah, most consonant sounds, but there are some exceptions there. However, common variants of the and r are acceptable and widely intelligible. So people can say think, then it doesn't make a difference. People can still understand. Then and then itu masih sama-sama, and ready with a trill R or ready, it's the same. But other than that, most consonant sounds need to be really, really intelligible. The pronunciation of F as P. Ini pasti, okay. Some people think of Vespa and Pesfa nih nanti. Okay. Coffee sounding like copy will create misunderstanding, right? Similarly, replacing ch with sh would make chair sound like shares, and then it will also threaten intelligibility. Okay, like for example, he bought 1,000 chairs, as opposed to he bought 1,000 shares. See, chairs and shares. Okay, is he going to do a party or is he going to actually invest on some kind of shares? It's different. So most consonant sounds need to be taught to your students. Yeah, but the and r are the exceptions. The second one. Okay. The next one is consonant clusters at the beginning or in the middle of a word. Consonant clusters. Some people like to add extra sound to consonant clusters to make it easier to pronounce. There will be an example after this. Yeah. For instance, stone is pronounced like seton. Okay. Yeah. Things like that. That's consonant clusters. The next one is a vowel length. Yeah, there needs to be a clear distinction between long and short vowels. There should be a difference between fill and feel. Okay, there are many examples. Yeah, especially with the word beach. Okay, short e, it will affect differently. Back and back. And the next one, the last one, is nuclear or sentence stress. Okay, the placement of stress in a sentence shows the emphasis of the speaker and therefore affects its interpretation. So different when you say, I've rented a flat, and I've rented a flat. They will create different interpretation. Okay, so anybody, do you still remember the interaction between Rush and theory? Kira-kira ada nggak nih consonants yang
yes
which one?
Sheep
oh, yeah. Consonant cluster kayaknya Anisa.
Hungry
yang pertama
eight. Dengan
hello.
I hate dengan eight.
Hate. So that belongs to consonant.
Chief and chef.
That's the vowel length, right?
Yes. And is eight. The pronunciation in the vocal, ma'am?
In the
vowel.
On yeah.
Chef.
Yeah, that's the consonant. Yeah. Chief. Chef, right. Okay, yes. Thank you, Ronnie. In the consonant. And the consonant cluster, do you remember? But at least, yeah, we know that sometimes people say the word stamp as stamp. Yeah, you add something to it to make it easier, or even you simplify. Instead of saying context, it becomes contact. Okay, and it's different, right? And then we do have problems with this, right, Indonesians, especially if there are five consonants at the same time, like the last word, how do you say it? If it is word and is, yeah, okay there, yeah. If it is three consonants, learned.
Thirst.
Okay lah, yeah. Mulai susah nih. Yeah, four consonants. Fourths. What about five consonants at the same time?
Twelve.
I do have difficulties, actually. Okay. An example of Russian theory about vowel length. Tadi itu ada tuh. Remember?
Vowel length.
Sheep and chip. Remember?
Yes.
Sheep. And okay, sheep. Remember?
And yes.
It's not a sheep, sir. It's a duck. It's a duck.
It's a rabbit.
Rabbit.
Maksudnya kan cheap ya, murah ya. Yeah, I didn't buy it cheap.
It's cheap. Okay, it's but cheap. Raj thought that it is chip computer chip.
Murah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And the next one is sentence stress. I need my drink, so I'm going to ask you to just listen to the video about sentence stress. Steph, that's okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Yep. Is it on?
Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. That was almost robotic, wasn't it? Without feeling. Robot, Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Doesn't sound like good English. Let's put some feeling into it. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. There's a clear understanding there for the listener that it's Sue, not Sarah, not Samantha, not Jeffrey, but Sue might be singing. That was sentence number one, of course. Sentence number two. Let's put the emphasis on the modal verb, might. It's only a possibility. It's not definite. It's not will. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Sentence number three. We're talking about singing is the key moment here. Not acting, not directing, singing. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. Sentence number four. The opera, not the theatre, not the street, not the party. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. There I really raised my voice as though I was surprised by this fact. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. That's kind of like, wow, isn't it fantastic for Sue? Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend. It's unexpected. And sentence number five, not tomorrow, not tonight, not next week, weekend. Here's the important word. Listen for it. I'm going to slow down for it and give it more melody than the rest of the words in the sentence. Sue might be singing in the opera at the weekend.
Okay. Got it? Now we check, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Sue might.
Okay. So we are going to do activity six. This is going to be the last activity. Actually, we have like six activities. Volunteers needed. Okay. I need I need four volunteers. What would you put?
We need three already. We have three already. Bu Judy, Bu Hasri, Bu Paroni.
Okay, so what I need to do, I need you to do is actually read. Okay, I have six sentences with different sentence stress. Okay, now others, those who volunteers will read, you can read any numbers, yeah? Do not start from one, yeah, you just choose. Others need to guess. Oh, she is reading sentence number one. She is reading sentence number two and things like that. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
And we have the fourth one, Ibu Anissa. Okay, so we have four people.
Okay. Yeah. Who's going to read her or his sentence first?
Perhaps we should start with Ibu Juni first because...
Okay, Ibu Juni.
Okay, I'm going to
tell them.
Don't
yeah?
tell anyone which
don't tell one anyone. To read.
Okay, please guess which one I read.
Okay.
Jack will cycle to the restaurant.
Number two.
Is that true, Ibu Juni?
Okay. Yes.
Obviously.
Obviously. For two obvious. Okay, and then number two, the next one, who's going to be number two?
The second person to read it is, let's have Ibu Hasri.
Ibu Hasri, yes.
Thank you, Bira. Okay, I will.
Yes.
Jeff cycled to the restaurant tonight.
Number one. And... Wow. Is it number one, Ilya?
Yeah, that's right. Jack cycled to the restaurant tonight.
Jack will cycle to the restaurant tonight. Okay. Okay. The next one. Who's going to read?
Pak Roni.
Okay. Jack will Jack will cycle to the restaurant tonight.
Number five.
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 Okay.
Jack and the last one will be Ibu Anissa.
Ibu Anissa.
Okay, thank you. Jack will cycle to the restaurant tonight.
Number four. Okay.
Correct.
Okay. So when Pak Roni said something like, Pak Roni, which one is Pak Roni? Tadi number five, yeah?
Pak Roni chose number five, yes.
Just number five, yeah. Jack will cycle to the restaurant tonight. What does it mean, actually?
Meaning that Jack will cycle to a restaurant, not any other places, and it happened tonight. Restaurant. The focus is on the restaurant,
not to cinema or what.
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. What about number two? If you stress on the wheel, and then what does it mean?
Jack already planned it and actually will execute it.
Will execute. Okay. Yes. Thank you very much. Do you still remember how Putri did her reading? Putri, yeah, the one from voice.
Almost like robotic?
No, almost like robotic. We don't want our students to be like that, right? So please do consider teaching this kind of sentence stress to your students. Okay. Now, this is also another video. It's a confirmation, actually. The confirmation is from people from the inner circle. They now are aware that this English as a lingua franca happens, that English is not their language. It is everybody's language now, okay? Please pay attention to this, and then probably you want to highlight on things that you that interest you.
What we're talking about here is English being used as a global communications tool, as I said before, and that means that the aim of pronunciation teaching has shifted maybe from where it was in the past. So we're not talking about necessarily acquiring a native speaker accent. We're talking about making sure that your learners are intelligible in this global use of English, this global English space. Okay, here we go. Great. And pronunciation teaching certainly is not an optional extra. It's important, I think, to understand just how significant pronunciation is in terms of impacting communications and intelligibility. And I think this little illustration here really helps to illustrate this point. So this person is also talking about or making the point that they are able to listen and they don't have to concentrate to understand. They can understand almost everything, and yet the speaker's accent is different from mine. So we're talking about making sure that your students, your learners are able to use their understanding of English sounds and the aspects of pronunciation across a whole range of accents. And it's certainly not an optional extra, because in fact research shows that up to 2/3 of miscommunication between speakers using English is down to pronunciation. Up to 2/3 of the problems that people have when they're using English to communicate is thought to be because of specifically pronunciation. So not grammar, not vocabulary, but pronunciation. So absolutely crucial to make sure that we're doing this with our learners. And then the third point here, I guess, in terms of international intelligibility, is that we certainly don't have to teach everything. We don't have to correct every pronunciation error error or deviation. What we do want to do is focus on those sounds and aspects of the English sound system, which are essential, relevant, and also achievable for our learners. That's really important, I think.
Okay. So what things that you get from the video?
Can I, ma'am, share?
Yes, sure. My idea. Sure. Yeah, Ibu Juni.
Okay. From the video that I guess we can sum up that what we need to focus to student is teaching them pronunciation, but not always correct their pronunciation if they make mistakes.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So the focus is only for the essential, the relevant, achievable sounds. So if they make mistake, it's okay. If we correct them directly, so it sometimes they don't want to speak and afraid of making mistake again. So yeah. I guess we can ask them to imitate the pronunciation by copying or imitating from the song. I guess that's all. Thank you.
Okay, so one of the ways to help your students probably by imitating from songs, that's what you said. Yeah, do not rightly correct your students' pronunciation. Because they might not want to speak later. Yeah, because they are being corrected all the time. Very good. What is it then? Proposal. Anything else? Look, number one, the objective is actually for international intelligibility, not native speaker accent. Yeah, because I mean, achieving near native speaker accent is all close to impossible in my case. Yeah, in my case, I will not be like native speaker. It's very difficult. But as long as you are intelligible, okay, you will do just fine. And please do not consider pronunciation teaching as optional extra, right? Because like how many miscommunication happens? Two-thirds of miscommunication happens because of mispronunciation. Okay, so it is very important. Do not consider it as an extra, as an option. Okay, anything else that you would like to say from this video? Nope.
What we're talking about.
Yeah, so the purpose is actually to make your students be able to be heard, to be understood, so that the other person, the other interlocutors, do not need to think, you don't need to think to be to understand you. Okay, I don't need to concentrate. I don't have to concentrate to understand what you are saying. So that's the thing. Okay. That was about pronunciation. Professor Barbara Seidhofer actually studied about the deviant grammatical items in ELF communication. Those five things are actually ungrammatical, in terms of the native speaker grammar, right? However, it is okay because even though you are doing these five things, you can still be considered as understood. Yeah, it is considered unproblematic in ELF communication. The first one is the omission of us in third person singular. It happens a lot. It happened to me as well, right? Yeah, he looked very sad. It's common. Yeah, but still you can be understood. Should be he looks very sad. Or sometimes we interchange the use of who and which. It should be interchangeably. Or here, the omission of article. Yeah, it happens a lot. Okay, the next one is substituting bare infinitive with ing. I look forward to see you. Should be to seeing you. And then the last one here, the universal tag. Whatever it is, isn't it? It happens a lot. So that's in terms of grammar, but still you can be understood. And then the next one, this is mentioned by several people. Achil also mentioned about this communication strategies. Yeah. Okay. In order to be understood during English as a lingua franca, when you do ELF, okay, you do a lot of negotiation as well as adaptation. Okay. Some people say that they are often defined as key features of ELF interactions. Speakers negotiate meaning as they engage in a conversation, adapting their skills and needs to those of their partners. That happens a lot, yeah? It happens, Achil mentioned about this, okay? Negotiating, adapting. Now, misunderstandings in ELF interactions are often resolved either by topic change or by other strategies such as repetition or rephrasing. Okay. If you remember Raj and Thierry did a lot of repetition, right? But it was a wrong repetition. He should have done a rephrasing, right? And then he also did a topic change. When he was talking about iRabbit, and then suddenly he asked for the chief, okay, the boss, of things like that. So this kind of communication strategies are also worth teaching to your students so that they can be intelligible and that they can be understood. Okay. Any questions? Now let's see. It's almost 11 o'clock. This is what the take that we have from teaching English as a lingua franca or and teaching English as a foreign language. What do we have here? If we do teach English as a lingua franca, we are going to focus more on native, non-native speakers, right? Because they are the most users. And then focusing also on intelligibility. And of course, the cultures of the non-native speakers. And then there should be also sample dialects coming from the non-native speakers. That's only fair. Okay? Now, if we contrast that with teaching English as a foreign language, this is what happens. We focus on native speakers. Okay. And then the kind of pronunciation that they have, like the pronunciation of Olivia. Remember Olivia? That's the kind of received pronunciation, the kind of British English that people use, the received pronunciation. As well as the cultures of the native speakers, as well as the simple dialogues of native speakers. Ladies and gentlemen, the books that we are using, actually they are printed by Oxford University Press, Macmillan, Pearson, Cambridge, right? Okay, those are the books that we use when we teach EFL, right? Okay, and then what's in the book? There are cultures of the native speaker, sample dialogues as well. So I'm so proud to be a LIA person because we have our own book, right? So big hands for those people from the curriculum and then materials department. Okay, because we dare to do our own materials. Now, based on this teaching English as a foreign language as opposed to teaching English as a lingua franca, isn't it tempting actually that we teach English as a lingua franca? What do you think? Okay. Should we teach English as lingua franca then? Anybody wants to answer? Someone is talking, but I cannot hear what he was saying.
But we maybe we could teach them now with let's say standard English, but we cannot avoid we have our own dialect.
Mm-hmm.
It's something that we cannot avoid. So I think, although we try to speak with a certain accent, yeah. Yeah, maybe you have seen yang iklan di kampung English itu ya.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. What happened in
kampung? Aneh gitu ya.
In Kediri, right?
Yeah. Unless you are Rich Brian, maybe it's a different case where he is really like native like.
Mm-hmm.
But the way he nurtured the language also in a different way. Yeah. Not by learning, by nurturing, by actively involving in doing the communication with those who are really native speakers and get I think one in a million is one in a billion. Maybe Rich Brian can do it. Yeah, he's not a native speaker, but he is really fluent. Yeah.
Mm.
So maybe there are others. Yeah. But anyway, I think for us, we should make the inner circle a reference, but in the process, maybe there will be something that we cannot, things that we can avoid. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I think that's all. Thank you.
Okay. I don't know, but it one you are breaking up, but I try to understand here. What you are saying is that you will be you will agree to the intro to the first one, yeah, that ELF be introduced in the curriculum, right? Not replacing EFL, because you still need the English from the native speakers. Is that it?
Yes, so like should be a standard. Yes, so like the English from the inner circle is the standard, but we cannot avoid having our own accents, etc.
Okay. So if you have to choose between the first one, should ELF be introduced in the curriculum or replace EFL, you will choose that it's going to be introduced in the curriculum.
I think it's just for maybe like for knowledge, but in terms of learning the language, I think it's like
okay. Thank you, Juan. Atil and Sri. Yes, please.
Ibu Sri first
or Atil first?
It's okay, you may start.
Okay. All right. In my opinion, when we teach the language, then we teach the standard language.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, whatever the language is. It's just like when we learn Bahasa Indonesia, we learn the standard one.
Mm-hmm.
But then, I believe as a teacher, we give the roots to the students,
mm-hmm.
right? The basic things.
Mm-hmm.
That's the standard one. And then when it's time for them to spread their wings, and then they can watch TV, watch anything from the internet. So that's the lingua franca one.
Mm-hmm.
So we teach them the standard English, but we also, if we have time, we can introduce them about this lingua franca. So once they have to step, take a bigger step to other parts of the world, so they understand, okay, this is accepted, this is not, or something like that. Mm-hmm. So they understand also. I think it's similar with any language, any other language that we learn is the same. Like, we learn the standard one. So we teach the standard one. Thank you, Ibu.
Thank you, Bu Acil. Jadi, the standard is, at least we have something to hold on to, right? Okay. Yeah, Sri. Ibu Sri.
Yeah, I agree with Ibu Novi. So basically, when we are learning, of course, there should be rules. There should be something to hold on to. So that answers the question for me.
ELF can be introduced in the curriculum. If we are talking about LIA, I guess it can be introduced through English for special purposes like communication in English, because they are going to use it to communicate. Mm. Yeah, but maybe for different programs, we can still use EFL in teaching them. But then when they really need to use it as a tool of communication, then ELF can be introduced, I guess. Thank you.
Thank you, Sri. Okay, yeah. Anissa, do you want to add something?
Is it okay, ma'am?
Yeah.
All right. So I basically agree with most of us that EFL is still the standard one. You mentioned mm-hmm. about the books. Mm-hmm. I'm now mentioning about the tests. Mm-hmm. You know, going to universities and mm-hmm. blah, blah, blah. There will be mm-hmm. standardized tests. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And of course, they will use standardized English. Mm-hmm. With the ELF, somehow... Pak Idwan mentioned about Richiga, and actually we have some students who are like that. I mean, mm-hmm. they learn English from playing games, mm-hmm. YouTube videos, and things like that. So they are native-like, mm-hmm. and they sound much better than us, the teachers. Mm-hmm. And but of course, it's not... the same with the grammar development. I mean, even the native speakers, not all native speakers speak like Obama, for example.
Oh, yeah.
Right? How about, okay, siapa after Obama?
Biden.
Biden. No,
Trump.
Sebelumnya Trump. Nah, Trump. For example, okay. Okay, let's say Trump. His English is not that good. Or Steve Harvey. One of the best speaker right now in America, okay, the comedian, mm-hmm. Even subject object pronoun uh-huh. are interchangeable for them, which it's okay. Gonna be absolutely confusing for the standardized English, but they are native speakers. And not to mention, our students are now millennials who, if you are more into social media, they do not really open to criticism, because I can do better by doing this. Mm. I am right now someone. I have millions of followers.
Yeah.
So why small things like grammar interfere with my fame, for example, mm-hmm. things like that.
Yeah.
So for me here, it's the purpose of the communication. Like in Lingua Franca, I said that it's a language that unites. So mm-hmm. unite who with whom? So mm-hmm. if it is a global citizen like us right now, international, when we are talking internationally, so it's EFL definitely. But when we are, let's say, having business communication to certain part of the world, okay, then we need to know the lingua franca better. Like Lia Cibubur once had a client with a company that is bought by a Japanese, mm-hmm. Of course they learn English, but mm-hmm. then when they have the board of directors coming, mm-hmm. they still have problems because they are Japanese. Mm-hmm. So they also need to learn the English as lingua franca at that time, not only English as a standardized one.
Yep.
So yeah, I think they will be hand in hand in our curriculum, and yep. I'm proud to be a LIA teacher because yep. we have the pronunciation part in our book, although it is still the non-significant other corner. Usually only a part, an activity or so, not so much, mm-hmm. but it's a start compared to our national textbooks. It's much better. Again, thank you to the curriculum people. So yeah, it's not replacing, introducing, okay, and we've been doing that in the year.
We've been doing that in the year. Wow, thank you very much.
There is an answer here from P3 in the chat. Shall I read it?
Yeah, sure.
I choose to introduce instead of replace it. We should teach the correct English.
when students acquire the correct or standard English, it won't be difficult for them to put the ELF into their day-to-day communication. If you put the other way around it, it will be more difficult for students to get the standard.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, very good answers, everybody. But still, there are many people who try to teach lingua franca. But up till now, okay, it's not practical. What after the evaluation, what they come up with is not practical. And then, of course, it's not doable. I mean, it's very difficult to apply. Because which standard, again, we go back to Achille's and then everybody else's answers earlier. We need to, to go to a certain standard. We need to choose a certain standard, right? If not, okay, how will the class sessions be? Okay, now, this is what, again, a kind of wrap up. ELF, it's a communication tool, yeah, again, and not a language variety. Still, again, it cannot replace a standard variety in class. Okay, there are some findings. Remember the findings from Ibu Barbara and Ibu Jennifer. They have great relevance, yeah, for our TEFL. So please do introduce that into your curriculum. They can be incorporated into your language classes by, of course, translating and adapting them to students' needs. But of course, it's also important that students be exposed not only to native speaker accents, but also non-native speaker accents of English. And remember, it once said earlier something like, it's like one in a million that you have a chance to really speak to native speakers, right? Yeah. Anissa said something about, yeah, akhirnya you speak to all to people from Japan using English. Again, you have difficulties. See? Okay, so please do expose your students also to non-native speakers accent. Okay, and then I'm going to wrap it up by the saying from by the statement from Ibu Penny here. Of course, yeah, we would like to show diversity. In order to show diversity and allow for deviation to take place, there should be a norm to follow. Okay, so that a standard version is needed for teaching. So that's basically what Achille said in the first place. So, okay. So Achille Ur, then it becomes Achille Ur because you think about the same thing. Okay. Yep. I think that's it then from me. The three of us, there are three of us, would like to say, I would like to say thank you. Thierry would like to say merci. And then Raj would like to say then you what? Okay, hope that you can learn something from this session and give you food for thoughts, yeah, the next time you teach in your class. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for coming. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you.
I'll give it back to Ibu Ira. Yes.
Thank you.
And the winner is
lunch, Ibu Celestine for the fruit.
Bu Celestine.
That was really awesome, right? We get to learn a lot today. Thank you. If you do think so, give me thumbs up. Got 2, 7, 10. Okay. Oh, awesome. And also some chats. Thank you, Buyas, and so on. Thank
you're
you
very much. Welcome. My pleasure.
All right. So are we going to announce the winner of the book today? Jing.
Yes. And then
yes,
I leave
please.
It back. I leave it to you.
Oh, okay.
Because you have the data.
Oh, what do you think, Pak Tamba? Are we going to announce it now? Or we're going to contact you when you win?
Baira.
Yes.
Decide now.
Oh, just decide now. Yeah. My decision. Oh.
Okay. Sorry to put the pressure on you, Bu Ira.
No pressure.
Maksudnya apa tuh?
No pressure.
So, I believe right now she's confused.
Choose me.
Usually we start with an A, Ibu Ira.
No, we start with the speaker. Come on. Don't be so mean to me. Let's see. We have a lot of names here, but from the beginning until the end, I see that the active person is Ibu Fitri. From Ibu Fitri is from Cibubur, ya?
From yes. Kelapa Gading, Bu Juni.
Do you mean Fitri W?
Fitri W, yes.
Yes, Fitri Wahyuni from Cibubur.
Yes. So the winner is Ibu Fitri, yeah. Hey. Ibu Fitri nanti jangan lupa persenannya saya ya.
Berapa lembar? Persenannya berapa lembar?
Okay, so bisa tambah so you contact Ibu Fitri about the book and so on, right? Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for bearing with us.
Okay, one more, Bu Ira. Sorry, to interrupt. Don't forget to fill in the feedback, right? Yeah, nanti yang nggak dapat, itu nggak.
Yeah, so feedback form is in the chat. Please complete it so that we can contact you for the PowerPoint slide and especially for Ibu Fitri to send you the book.
Okay. Say something.
No. Just don't forget to take pictures. Itu aja.
So smile, everyone. Hang on.
So who's going to take pictures?
Okay, Daman, can you please take pictures, Daman?
Okay, I will do. Okay, please stop sending chats for a while and look at the camera.
Camera on, please.
Yes. Okay, I'm going to count until 3, 1. Okay, the first slide. 1, 2, 3. Okay, wait. Is okay. Number 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, and number 3. Okay, number 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Because there's no photo in the last slide.
Okay,
that's enough. Thank you.
Thank you very much for attending the session.
Thank you, everyone. Bye.
Have a nice
Thank you very much. Bye bye. Assalamualaikum.
See you next time.
Bye, Aili.
See you in the next one. Bye bye, everyone.
Okay, bye-bye. Okay. Yep. Nice. Oh, yeah.
You're very much welcome. Thank you. Bye. To Anissa.
Bye-bye. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Hello, Micha.
So sad. Cannot get the book.
boleh pinjam nanti dari Cibubur.
Oh, yang punya Fitri, kenapa yang mau minjemin Anissa ya?
Lah, kan kita satu ruangan.
Jadi properti Cibubur kayaknya.
Jadi properti Cibubur kayaknya.
Itu apa namanya?
Kenapa Fitri?
Can we get the PPT or the
material?
Yes, you will get the PowerPoint slide by the that you complete the feedback form that you can find in the chat.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
They're going to be sent to you, Ibu Fitri.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Don't worry, Ibu.
Okay, bye-bye.
We'll send it to you after we finish reading it, Ibu Fitri.
Udah lecek dong.
Emang cuma Miss Astrid doang yang ambisius. I like you.
Berarti kita gantian dulu bacanya ya.
Baru. Iya, aduh.
Aku kasih siapa jadinya?
Udah nggak baru lagi.
Ya, aku kasih Astrid aja ya.
Yes, ma'am.
Stay with me dulu. Kita copy di Aladdin, baru.
Okay, bye-bye. See you. Bye. Stay healthy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bu.
Okay. Alright. Yeah, thank you Pak Wijang. Okay. Ini, thank you. Ada Pak Darus juga, Pak Ganda, and yeah. Okay, John Rhys, yes. Thank you. And we have Doris Kinaga and Alia. Okay, yeah, thank you. Yeah, hope to see you again in the next episode. Okay. Okay. What can we do with this one? Put them in the waiting room.
My God, you could be.
Do you want to close the